described in Captioned Media Program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
May I inquire, Mr. Cratchit, what you're doing with that shovel full of coal?
Why, I beg your pardon, sir, but the outer office is intensely cold, and my fire...
Dear, your fire?
I should have said your fire, sir.
Yes, sir.
It shows symptoms of going out, and I thought I might venture to replenish it with a small quantity of coal.
Yeah. Well, of course, you know, it's very evident to me, you know, Mr. Cratchit, that you and I left apart. Oh, I see no help for it, sir. You don't pay for the coal, so you can afford to be reckless. Therefore, very evident to me, sir, you know, that my interest is not your interest. Nor my welfare, your welfare. Get on with your work, sir. That'll keep you warm enough. I'm not cold. Why should you be? When I am your senior, by a great many years, I fancy.
About a small shovel full of coal.
And none of your mumbling, you know, none of your mumbling. You have a wife and family to support, I understand.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. How many children have you got?
Around half dozen, sir. Three boys and three girls.
Tut, tut, tut. Can I afford a wife?
Yes, sir.
Hey?
I mean, no, sir.
Have I any children?
I don't know, sir.
Eh?
No. No, sir.
How much am I constrained to pay you a week for your services?
15 shillings, sir.
Be to your interest, sir, to see that you're worth it.
Thank you.
uncle.
And God save you.
Bah! Humbug.
This Mr. Humbug? You can't mean that, I'm sure.
I do mean it, sir. What right have you to be merry? What reason have you to be merry? You're poor enough.
Come then. What right have you to be dismal? What reason have you to be morose? You're rich enough.
Bah! Humbug.
Oh, don't be cross, uncle.
How can I help being cross, sir, when I live in such a world of fools as it is? A merry Christmas. What's Christmas time to you, sir? The time for paying bills without money. Time for finding yourself a year older? Not a penny richer. If I had my way, sir, every fool who goes about saying Merry Christmas should be boiled with his own pudding and buried with a stake of olive through his heart. He should.
Uncle!
Nephew, you keep Christmas your way. Let me keep it in mind.
Keep it? But you don't keep
it. Well, let me leave it alone then. Much good has it done you. Much good will it ever do you.
It's the only time I know of in the long calendar of the year when men and women seem by one consent to open their shut hearts freely. And therefore, though it's never put a scrap of gold or silver in my pocket, I believe it has done me good and will do me good. And I say, God bless it.
Hear, hear. Hear, hear.
Mr. Cratchit, if I hear another word from you, you'll keep your Christmas by losing your situation. Dear, 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 dear. Quite a powerful speaker, sir. When are you going to go into Parliament?
Don't be angry, Uncle. Come, dine with us tomorrow.
I'll see you.
But why? Why?
Why did you get married?
Because I fell in love.
Because I fell in... Good evening.
You never came to see us before that happened. Why give that as a reason for not coming now?
Good evening, sir.
But I want nothing from you. I ask nothing of you.
Well, you won't get it, so you won't be disappointed, will you?
We've never had a quarrel to which I've been party. So why not let us part friends?
Good evening, sir.
Well, I'm sorry with all my heart to find this irrelevant. But I've made the trial in homage to Christmas, and I'll keep my Christmas humor to the last. So a Merry Christmas, Uncle.
Good evening, sir.
And a Happy New Year.
You're a noisy devil. That's what you are, sir.
Merry Christmas, Bob Cratchit. And the same to you, sir, and many of them. And not forgetting your good lady, Mrs. Fred.
Thank you, Cratchit. A Merry Christmas to you. A Merry Christmas.
I notice.
It's 7 o'clock, sir.
That clock's fast. By the way, I suppose you'll want all day off tomorrow, eh?
Well, sir, if it's quite convenient.
It isn't convenient. It isn't fair. If I were to stop half a crown for it, oh, you'd be mightily ill-used, I'd be bound, wouldn't you? Don't think I'm ill-used, do you? When I have to pay a whole day's wages. No work.
It only happens once a year, sir.
That's a pretty excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December. Well, I suppose you've got to have it. Here, there's the key. You see, sir, that you're here all the earlier next morning.
Good night, sir, and a Merry Christmas.
Bah, humbug.
Now, or will you let the ladies and gentlemen continue to enjoy themselves?
Call silence for the loyal toast.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for the Right Honourable the Lord Mayor of London. My lord.
Lords, ladies and gentlemen, Her Most Gracious Majesty, the Queen.
People out of their wits.
Ebenezer Scrooge, for only you can see me.
Much you want with me?
Much.
Oh, I am.
In life, I was your partner, Jacob Marley.
In life? Why do you trouble me?
It is required of everyone that the spirit within him should walk abroad among his fellow men. And if that spirit goes not forth in life, it is condemned to do so after death. My spirit never walked beyond the narrow limits of our money-changing hall. So I cannot rest. I cannot stay. I cannot linger anywhere.
You are fettered. Why?
I wear the chain I forged in life. I made it, link by link. Would you know the weight and length of the coil you bear yourself?
Speak words of comfort to me, Jacob Marley. Speak words of comfort.
Comfort? I have none to give. I am here to warn you, to save you, if that be possible.
To warn? To save me? From what?
From such a fate as mine. To wander through the world and witness what I cannot share, but might have shared on earth, and turn to happiness.
But you... were always a good man of business, Jacob. Business. Mankind would have been my business. Charity, forbearance, benevolence, all were my business, as they should be yours. Now heed me, for my time is short. You will be haunted by three spirits. Without their visits, you cannot hope to shun the path I tread. You shall behold the visions of a Christmas past, a Christmas present, and a Christmas yet to come. Expect the first when the clock strikes midnight tonight. Marley! Look to see me no more. Marley!
To show you the things that have been. Look back beyond the gulf of vanished years.
The money is due and must be paid.
But, sir, that's impossible.
Then I shall have no alternative but to take immediate steps to recover it.
But, sir, you must see that if...
That is the way I conduct my business.
You don't mean... sell us up?
That is precisely what I do mean.
But, sir, I couldn't work in the hospital.
Mr. Scrooge, I beg of you.
Good day.
You can't do this. You can't be so unjust.
Give us a little more time. A week.
Please. Ask you for a little breathing space, a little time in which to pay. That's all.
Enough of this, Bill. I am ready to make allowances for your feelings as a woman. But I must ask you to leave my business affairs alone. When you marry me, I shall insist. Take leave of your senses.
I've tried hard not to believe what they've said about you. I'd give anything not to believe it now. But the evidence of my own eyes and ears, I must believe. You are not always so. But I can see now that one passion and one passion only engrosses you. Gain.
What then? Even if it were so, I'm not changed towards you.
You are changed. Changed in every way. You're not the man. Our contact's an old one. Made when we were poor and content to be so. May we happy. Alone. In the life you've chosen. But...
inside, I could scarcely help seeing him. His partner's on the point of death, I hear. And there he sat, alone. Quite alone in the world, I do believe.
Spirit, I cannot bear it. Haunt me no more.
I told you these were the shadows of the things that have been, that they are what they are. Do not blame me.
Take me back! It's 1 o'clock, I know it is. Under compulsion and learn the lesson which is working now. If you have aught to teach me, let me profit by it.
Touch my robe, and you shall see how your poor clerk, with his paltry 15 shillings a week, which you so grudgingly dole out to him, keeps Christmas. Touch my robe.
He was a cripple, and that it might be pleasant for them to remember upon a Christmas day who made lame beggars walk and blind men see. But he's growing stronger. Yes, growing strong and hearty.
I wish I could believe you, Bob, but I'm afraid.
For what we are about to receive, may the Lord make us truly thankful.
I can already vouch for it. And its flavor will, I know, surpass my utmost expectations. With the mashed potato and the apple sauce, it will, I am sure, present a delightful combination that we shall remember until our dying day.
That's the best goose we ever had, Mother.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I've eaten too much.
And even now, we haven't eaten at all.
You laugh.
Laugh. I envy them.
tell me that Tiny Tim will live?
I see a vacant seat in the poor chimney corner, and a crutch without an owner, carefully preserved. If these shadows remain unaltered in the future, the child will die.
Oh, tell me that he'll be spared.
If he is like to die, had he not better do it and decrease the surplus population?
I give you a toast. I give you Mrs. Scrooge, the founder of the feast.
The founder of the feast, indeed. I wish I had him here. I'd give him a piece of my mind to feast upon. I hope he'd have a good appetite for it.
But, my dear, the children, Christmas Day.
It should be Christmas Day, I'm sure, on which one drinks the health of such an odious, stingy, hard, unfeeling man as Mr. Scrooge. You know he is, Robert. Nobody knows it better than you do, poor fellow.
My dear, Christmas Day.
Well, I'll drink his health for your sake and the day's, not his. He'll be very merry and very happy, I've no doubt. Here's Mr. Scrooge's health.
Now, children, all together, Mr. Scrooge's health. Mr. Scrooge's health.
Mr. Scrooge's health.
And now, Tiny Tim will sing to us.
Yes, I do. Sing. What shall I sing?
Hark the herald in.
Yes, hark the herald in.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy now.
Come now and see how others keep Christmas.
Of the future, I fear you more than any specter I have seen. You are about to show me shadows of the things that have not been, but will be in the time to come. And as I hope to live to be another man from what I was, I am prepared to bear you company.
I don't know much about it either way. I only know he's dead.
When did he die?
Last night, I believe.
Why, what was the matter with him? I thought he'd never die.
Heaven knows.
What's he done with his money?
Left it to his company, perhaps. He hasn't left it to me. That's all I know.
How are you?
Very well. How are you?
So old Nick has got his own at last.
So I'm told. Cold, isn't it?
Seasonable for Christmas time.
Oh, yes.
You're not a skater, I suppose.
Oh, no, no. I've got something else to think about.
I do not see myself in my accustomed place. Where am I? Why am I not there?
Staring as if you were afraid, woman. Who's the worse for the loss of a few things like this? Not a dead man, I suppose.
Open this bundle, old Joe, and let me know the value of it. I ain't afraid to be the first, nor afraid for them to see it.
There's your account. I wouldn't give another sixpence.
Now mind, Joe.
Eight shillings. I always give too much to ladies. It's a weakness of mine.
And now unto my bundle, Joe.
Bed curtains.
Bed curtains.
You don't mean to say you took them down, rings and all, with him lying there?
Why not?
You was born to make your fortune, and you will certainly do it.
Here, don't drop the oil on the blankets.
His blankets?
Whose else's? He's likely to take cold without them, I dare say.
Hope he didn't die of anything catching.
Oh, don't you be afraid of that. Now, you can look through that shirt until your eyes ache and you won't find a hole in it. It's the best he had. It'd have been wasted if it hadn't been for me.
What do you call wasting of it?
Putting it on him to be buried in, to be sure. I took it off him. Calico's just as becoming to the body. He couldn't have looked uglier than he did in that one. This is the end of it, you see. He frightened everyone away from him when he was alive to profit us when he was dead.
I see. The case of this unhappy man might be my own. My life tends that way now. Merciful heavens! What is that? Is this the man they spoke of? Neglected. Robbed. Hated. Can you not show me some tenderness connected with death? My little child. tiny Tim. Thy childish essence was from God.
I met Mr. Scrooge's nephew today, and he said to me, I'm heartily sorry for you, Mr. Cratchit, and heartily sorry for your good wife. So how he knew that, I don't know.
Knew what, my dear?
Why, that you were a good wife.
Everybody knows that.
Well observed, my boy. And he said, if there's any service that I can do for you, pray come to me. It almost seemed as though he had known our tiny Tim and felt with us. And I'm sure we shall none of us forget him, nor this first parting there has been among us.
Never, Father.
And I know that when we recollect how patient and how mild he was, although he was but a little child, we shall not quarrel easily among ourselves and forget poor tiny Tim in doing it.
No, Father.
I'm very happy. Very happy.
Now, Spirit, tell me, what man that was whom we saw lying dead? Nearer to the stone at which you point, tell me, are these the shadows of the things that will be? Or are they the shadows of the things that may be only?
They will. man. Oh, Merry Christmas to everyone. Happy New Year to all the world. Oh, here's the saucepan that the girl was in. Yes, and there's the door that old Marley's ghost came through. Yes, it's all right. It's all true. It all happened. Oh, hooray, hooray.
Glorious, glorious. Hey, boy. Hey, a Merry Christmas. It is Christmas Day, isn't it?
Why, of course.
I knew I hadn't missed it. Oh, the spirits have done it all in one night. Hey, do you know the poulter at the corner of the street next but one?
I don't know, I did.
An intelligent boy, a remarkable boy. Do you know if they've sold the prize turkey that they had hanging there?
It'll be hanging there now.
Well, you go and buy it.
Walker!
No, I'm in earnest. You go and buy it and bring it back here, and I'll tell you where to take it. And you come back with a man, and I'll give you a shilling. You come back in less than 5 minutes, and I'll give you half a crown.
Hooray!
Merry Christmas, my dear.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Who's that won't come and dine with you?
Uncle Scrooge.
Still, what's the consequence? He won't lose much of a dinner.
Oh. Indeed. Well, I think he'll lose a very good dinner.
Master in, my dear?
Yes, sir.
Can I see him, my love?
He's in the dining room, sir. I'll show you in.
He knows me. He knows me.
Mm-hmm. You sit there.
Fred.
Bless my soul, who's this?
It is I, your Uncle Scrooge. I've come to dinner. Will you let me in, Fred?
Why, it's Uncle Scrooge. It can't be. Will I? A Merry Christmas to you, Uncle. Come in. Come in and join us.
Welcome, Uncle. And a Merry Christmas.
Thank you, my dear. A Merry Christmas to you all.
A Merry Christmas.
So I did.
Goodbye, my darling. Goodbye, my darling.
Coming here at this time of day.
I'm very sorry, sir. I am behind my time.
I think you are, sir. I think you are.
There's only one thing here, sir. It shan't be repeated. I was making rather merry yesterday, sir.
So I tell you what it is, my fine fellow. I'm not going to stand it any longer.
And therefore, I'm sir, going to raise your salary.
Sir. You must be joking.
Never more serious in all my life, Bob. I'm going to raise your salary, and as for dining in, I'll be a second father to you.
God, yes.
No more work today, Bob. No work today. Make haste to your battery, Bob. They've been wanting it today, Bob. They've been wanting it today. A merry Christmas, Bob.
A merrier Christmas, my good fellow, than I've given you for many a year.
Go on now. Go on.
Hey.
Merry Christmas to all the world. Happy New Year to everyone. God bless us all. God bless us everyone.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.